time, regardless whether you got borrowed money or you just considering the optimal cost of your operation and the time, truly is money. In answer to your question about why wouldn't you carry them over the second year, or in our case, we would be very resource limited. If we wanted to do that, they would have to be off the property, or we would have to change our operation.
You have to have less cows.
Shrink the mother bird.
Right.
So that we could have those animals there and manage them like we would have to do in order to achieve the objectives. But kind of to back up, and philosophically, I don't think of our operation as a low input operation or a high input operation. I kind of think of operating for value, and considering the opportunity cost of the value of the animals and the other resources we work with, I look at every part of what we do and I try to decide for myself, you know, is there a net positive margin in the next cycle of the production method? And we've been in the cow-calf business for 30 years, and we've been in raising them onto the yearlings for 30 years, I guess. And we learn something every year, but I think, you know, our goal from a genetic standpoint was to be able to produce, and from an operating standpoint, grazing management and other management, would be to produce the finished animal, the 1,200 pounder, you know, at the end of the second summer or into the late fall of that. And to that effect, we've come awfully close, the people that got them after we had them have come awfully close. In our very best year, here in Nebraska, we were able to sell, there was 8 Mayborn calves in the following August, the year from I guess whatever age they were. You know, we got the whole group off, no cutbacks, no nothing, at 880 pounds on August 20th of the following year. And those animals, I think, had they gone into a good fall finishing program, people that have the brassicas, the other things that take them on into the late fall and early winter, I'm very confident those animals would qualify. And then a few years after that, we sold a group of 9 weights in the frost program. In late fall, and they would have been, had they not gone right down the road in Nebraska, had they gone to some little warmer climate or design program to finish in the late fall or early winter, they would have done the job. So to answer your question, what are we striving for in our operation, particularly from a genetic standpoint, is we would strive for a program genetically and operationally that would yield up 8 weights at an appropriate time in the mid to late summer period, if the right kind of operator could take them on and finish in the program.